Paul, thanks for joining us this morning. How much are you looking forward to tomorrow's game? You know, when you look at 2,500 fans going there, a packed out stadium, sounds like a proper football match.
Probably the same as every single one of them. Exactly the same. Excited, anxious, wondering what the result will bring, what will the game bring. And there's no better days for football fans. You know, I'm sure they'll be in work today now, all preparing. What time are we up? Where are we going for breakfast? What time do we leave? Will we nick a pint? Will we get 2 pints before the game? And how will our team play? So the biggest one I can affect is how the team will play. And that's something that we've worked very hard on this week.
Does it give everyone an extra boost when you hear these numbers and you see that support coming?
I think it's something that can be a challenge for players in relation to when you play for big clubs. Because the reality is, whether people like it or not, you can't lower your level of performance. If you lower your level of performance in most divisions, you will lose football games. So when you're playing for some of the bigger clubs in the league, whether that's right or wrong, you must be at it every week. Because if you're not, you get beat. It happened to us at Accrington. Yeah. We're credit to Accrington. They were better than us all over the pitch. So there's no freakiness, no shock about the result. It was a fair result. We've got to make sure that we turn up with the same level of desire as we did at Lincoln. Was them two levels the same? I'm not so sure they were. When we go to Cambridge tomorrow, I'm sure our supporters are wanting, demanding, expecting a performance, and it's something that we've got to try our best to give them.
I think naturally, in all due respect to Cambridge, people will draw comparisons to the Accrington trips. What challenges do they present?
Again, the division is very hard to compare teams. Mm. Cambridge are a promoted team that have had an excellent year last year under Mark. They've done fantastically well. They've jumped up a division and they've acclimatised themselves really well to the division. They've got some very good players. You know, the team plays well. They've adapted to different formations, to different styles, and they've got some good results. So tomorrow's a big game for both clubs. Yeah. It's not just a big game for Cambridge. It's a massive game for Ipswich Town as well. And that's what makes it a special game tomorrow.
Chance for momentum as well. And there are lots of fixtures coming up, aren't there?
I just keep going. So I just said to the press guys there, you know, football management, the next game's important. By the time you've played 46 games, every single one of them has equal importance. You're playing for 3 points. So tomorrow we'll approach the start of a tough week in relation to going to Cambridge. Have we prepared well? Have we prepared for Cambridge? Have we prepared for what they might do, what they might bring? But most importantly, how we're going to play. Because we've got to go there tomorrow and impose ourselves on the game.
Does this busy schedule present an opportunity to see the squad depth, and is it going to be called upon?
100%. I think if you look at the goals for column at the minute after 11 games, we're doing okay. Yeah. There's goals in the team. If you look at the goals against column, that's where we've got to improve. Because you can't continually give goals away and expect to win games. It doesn't work like that. So the habits you gain from how do you stop conceding goals are all habits of desire, work rate, you know, all them things that make it where you go the extra yard. So for us, it's been a learning curve after 11 games. I think the big disappointment in the 11 has only been Bolton. I think a lot of the other games have been 50-50, last-minute goals against whatever. But the reality is, if we want to get where we want to be, we've got to put a run of performances together consistently well. And that's over the next 35 games.
Decisions to be made, of course, as there is every week with team selection, but Bassant Salina coming back from international duty, and Connor took that opportunity really well.
100%. I think Bassant's been away, obviously, with Kosovo, which is great. I think we're going into a three-game week now where we've got a lot of players chomping to play. I think the challenge for us now is to pick the correct teams. Sometimes the result dictates whether it was the correct team, but from a manager's point of view, the correct team is the correct team. The result can only highlight whether it's good or bad. I think with the three games this week, one of the things we've learned from the Doncaster game, the level of performance can't go from the highs of Doncaster to the lows of Accrington. We have to get some middle ground, so that's something we're searching for.
Off the pitch, Paul, we've seen Peter Reid's involvement a little bit. He's a guy that you know so much about, and I'm sure if he was to be an addition to the group, a welcome one.
Oh, yeah. Listen, I think, you know, I worked with Peter for 3 years at Wigan. Peter's just a great guy. I think in the football world, you'll very, very rarely find someone who's as well-respected as Peter Reid, not just for the things he's done as a footballer, but also for the things he's done for the likes of Sunderland as a football manager. So, you know, again, I'm sure the club will announce something when the time's right. For me, obviously, if Peter was to come, it'd be great, not just for myself, but for the other staff and for the club in general. You know, for people with these amounts of experience around football clubs, it can only be good.